With four players out through bookings and injuries, I don't think anyone really thought they'd pose much of a problem. But they posed, as it turned out, a very big problem. They began to string their passes together. In one way or another, the England midfield was finding it very difficult to break through. England were getting absolutely nowhere. But after 25 minutes, Pierce floated a ball to the waiting head of Platt, and thank God, it was 1-0. By the second half, it was a lead we were lucky to hold on to. Gascoigne had brought down super sub Roger Milla for a penalty that made it 1-1. Before England even had time to realise what these underdogs were doing to them, Miller's through ball had put a Keke through to stroke it in, putting them 2-1 up. And they deserved it. England, sweeper system and all, were now being played off the park. But we somehow bounced back. With 10 minutes to go, the Cameroons let England off the hook. Lineker was crashed over for a penalty. He sent Nkono the wrong way. 2-2. This supposed walkover had developed into a very serious game of football.
Ekeke.
22 players began to wilt in the heat, and as the inevitable penalty shootout loomed, a very knackered Gascoigne momentarily perked up, threaded a ball of pinpoint accuracy through to Lineker, who was in turn sandwiched between Nkono and a clumsy defender. Another penalty. Ice-cool Lineker again made no mistake. It was 3-2, but with 15 minutes to go, the final whistle seemed hours in coming. Next stop, Turin. As the rest of the stadium quickly emptied, we sang and stayed behind for the customary one-hour lock-in. We didn't really need entertaining, but a constipated Carabinieri guard dog provided brief relief before we were herded back onto the awaiting hooli buses.